Good morning all. Am I audible? Good morning, friends. Jai Predictive Homeopathy.
Recording in progress.
Myself, Dr. Amit Gohil, Predictive Homeopath, and from Team Happy Gujarat. Tribute to our Master Samuel Hahnemann. We shall take blessing from our masters who taught us the dare to be wise. And in real sense, we are taking blessing from our guru, Dr. Prafull Vijaykar sir, who gave us this beautiful science. The homeopathy is mathematics. We remember our sir since last year. We missed our sir. And this is the day I am presenting you is nothing but the teachings of sirs and the knowledge I get from the source and the blessings I get from the source. Even my eyes become so sorry. We all are missing our sir. And you too, sir, I am here to present you everything. Without sir, I am nothing. I am bowing to sir. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Shakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri Guru Ve Namah. I I am sharing my gratitude to all the teachers and mentors. My mentors, Dr. Amrish Vijaykar sir, Dr. Anil Panchal sir, Dr. Nishant Gandhi sir, Dr. Asif sir, Dr. Siti Joshi sir, Dr. Nimesh sir, Dr. Anupam sir, and my guide, mentor and everything, Dr. Suketu Shastri sir, Dr. Jitesh Sosalia sir, Dr. Keir Patel and Dr. Rashi Patel ma'am, and all team Happy Gujarat. Thank you to all of you, because without this team and all my mentors and gurus and teachers, I am nothing. I am here to present you because of these teachers are there behind my back. Thank you all teachers and my mentors. So whatever knowledge I have acquired from the predictive homeopathy and my guru, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, I am trying to share with you. If there are any faults, those are mine and of my perceptions. And if you are benefited from this, then credit should go to my guru, Dr. Praful Vijaykar sir, and his predictive homeopathy. This is the real tribute to our sir, that when we are getting knowledge from the sir, and if we are benefited, we give credit to this predictive homeopathy and sir's teaching. So my chief aim is to create the right thought process of homeopathy. So please understand thought process without any prejudice. So begin with the topic. Sir always says that I do not see what mind does not know. If we have something in our back of mind, then we can see everything in the world. So this is what I'm stating with my case presentations on infertility. So we are starting with the case of infertility. Mrs. TVP, 27 Jan 2017, a 38 years female housewife. She got married twice, once got divorced due to marital disharmony, came to me with a complaint of primary infertility. She wanted to conceive. She belongs to Maharashtrian family, studied up to 7th standard, and due to lack of interest in study with a poor family condition, she left the study. Chief complaint. She came with the complaint of primary infertility with the following reports. Her hormonal profile done with USG pelvis. So hormonal profile shows FSH was normal, LH was normal, prolactin was normal, TSH was normal, and AMH was 0.15. It's very low. So these are the reports, 25th of Jan 2017, the thyroid in a normal range, 3.88, FSH 7.11, normal range, LH 2.65, prolactin 15.24. The AMH is very low. Very low is the range between 0.0 to 0.3 is very low, and that is AMH suggests there is no fertility or low fertility. So this was the case presenting to me. CBC report shows everything was okay, apart from the mild eosinophilia, 0.8. USG report shows 18 by 15 mm intramural fibroids. Left ovary not visualized. History of left ovarectomy done due to chocolate cyst. Husband semen analysis report was normal. So this was the USG report of 5th Jan 2017, suggestive of intramural fibroid, anterior wall uterus measuring 18 by 15 mm. Right ovary 31 by 19 by 17, left ovary not visualized. History of operated for the cyst. So this was the case with me. So again, we are going to detail the case. So associated complaint. So she had a constipation, stool unsatisfactory. In a Gujarati, they said jabardasti javu pade che. I will speak in English also, that she need to force to pass the stool. She had to take a laxative to pass the stool. And for constipation, she used to take warm water every night so that stool can be passed. Stool is soft. Another complaint she had is a flatulence. Third complaint was sneezing and running nose from dust allergy, and pain in abdomen, sometimes have involuntary urinations, especially when the sneezing, Query stress incident mostly occur in winters and aggravated in winter seasons. Past history, she had malaria once, history of pain in abdomen, fear of going to school, feel pain in abdomen in childhood. This was a childhood history. A chronic recurrent cold due to working in a water. She is a servant. She used to wash the clothes and vessels. History of skin disease. So for the skin disease, she had a faith in some religious cult which relieved her skin complaint. So we can think of some superstitious belief also. She said that when I use, in a Gujarati, they said, Nava cooker in Rasoiti allergy thai chai. She said that if she ate food cooked in a new cooker, then she got allergy. Query, aluminum poisoning. Fissure at anus, boil in perianal regions, no bleeding, occasional pus and cyst. Left ovarian cyst, query chocolate cyst, operated in 2009. And left renal stone. This was the past history. Physical general appetite was normal. If remain hungry, causes headache. Desire for spicy, especially chilies, aversion milk, houseless, thermally chilly, perspiration scanty on forehead, chest, axilla, no smell, stool and urine, nothing specific. Sleep, alert from the sound. She cannot remain alone at night. She had a fear of darkness and ghost. Sun cannot tolerate, feel giddiness, riding causes nausea and vomiting, tight clothing aggravates, desire, loose clothes. Menstrual history. So LMP was 25th of Jan 2017, last for 2 to 3 days. The previous LMP was 5th of Jan 2017. Spotting, irregular, sometime 20 days, scanty, spotting. Color dark brown, occasionally blackish, occasional clots. Before menses, there is a back pain, cramps in the back and limb pain. During menses, occasional pain, cramps in the leg. After menses, no complaint. She had a leukorrhea, white discharge, occasional itching, pain in urethra, which is relieved by urinations. Sexual history. Pain in vagina while doing sex. Sometimes spasm, it can be a vaginismus, coition, no desire, and enjoy it. Coitus, enjoyment, absence. Sexual activity weekly or once in every 15 days. Sexual desire is diminished due to pain. History of feeling as if being raped. Past history of abuse sexually in a first marriage. So this was just menstrual history and sexual history. We are going to the life history of the patients. So in the life history, in the first marriage in 2008, which lasted for the 4 years, after getting marriage, she said that she is being tormented by the husbands and in-laws. She said it is a tras tha. Husband no tras hato, swarthi hato, potana sukh mate juto, bairani kimmat kai nahi. काम धंधो नतो करतो व्यसन करतो जुगार आणतो पैसा मांगतो एंड द रिएक्शन वॉज वीपिंग सो दिस इज व्हाट हस्बंड इज व्हेरी टॉर्मेंटेड व्हेरी सेल्फिश एंड शी कैन नॉट वैल्यू द हर वाइफ शी कैन नॉट डू वर्क्स एंड शी इज एडिक्शंस एंड शी इज गैम्बलर एंड ऑलवेज बोरो मनी फ्रॉम दिस लेडी सो दिस लेडी इज बीइंग टॉर्मेंटेड बाय दिस सिचुएशंस एंड द रिएक्शन फॉर लेडी वॉज वीपिंग. She is doing all her work and also she is working in another home as a servant. She is earning to support the family by money. There is a strict domination in the in-laws. She is so much so timid and in in-laws beated her, humiliated in front of her family member. Even in hospital also, she is being tortured physically, mentally and sexually. ઘણી કોશિશ કરી બધું સારું થઈ જાય પણ પછી થયું નહીં એટલે ડિવોર્સ લો. શી ટ્રાઈડ મેની થિંગ્સ ટુ ગેટ બેટર એવરીથિંગ ઇન ધ ફેમિલી બટ ફાઇનલી શી ટુક ધ ડિવોર્સ. શી ઓલવેઝ પ્રેસ ટુ ગોડ દેટ હસબન્ડ વિલ બીકમ નોર્મલ ડ્યુ ટુ દેટ શી ફીલ્સ માય નેમ ઇઝ બીંગ સ્પોઇલ્ડ. શી ઇઝ વેરી સેન્સિટિવ ટુ ક્રિટિસિઝમ એન્ડ ધ બ્લેમ. શી સેડ કે મારું ભગવાનને પ્રાર્થના કરતી કે સુધરી જાય એના લીધે મારું નામ ખરાબ થાય છે. બધા બદનામ કરે સહન ના થાય કોઈ વાત ટાળે એ ના ગમે. એન્ડ શી ઇઝ વેરી સેન્સિટિવ ટુ ઇનજસ્ટિસ but suffer silently, and finally they land up with the mode of despair. Then she decided not to marry again. After divorce, she decided not to marry again because she has no interest. History of the torment too with her sister also. So she lost interest in married life. And that was a grief state of their lady. Then she had a second marriage. She want to work for self but doesn't like to marry because there is a tormented situation in a previous married life. So she didn't like to marry as there is so much torment in a married life. But she yelled to family as family forcefully insists her to get married. Because of this timidity, she yielded to that. She feels that loko badnam kare etle pachi mari ichcha vare marriage karya. So she feels that due to sensitivity of the blame by public, she goes against her wish to get married. She is so much so emotional and she is sensitive. If she saw someone crying, she feels like crying. So this was the end of the case. Now, how to probe this case? This is a very important aspect of predictive teaching, that there is a case history. And now how to probe the case? Can you have any inputs regarding this case? All audience, please. You can have a chat box. Yes, Dr. Imrana Sheikh, we can think of abuse in a marriage, element from, very good, fine. Abuse and tormented, actually she is tormented. She is tormented in a real sense. So we cannot take abuse and tormented. Yes, Dr. Rushali, emotion suppressed, very good. Domination history, very good. Exactly. Fine, Dr. Swapnil. Timidity, yielding nature. Yes, disposition is timidity, yielding nature. Very good. Weeping. Yes, it was again a dispositions, timidity. Yes, Dr. Anand, you are very good. Antagonism with self, we can think of. Very good. Sensitivity everywhere. Yes, fine. Anything else? Sora, sensitivity to opinion, syphilis is antagonism. Very good. Very good, Dr. Nitya. Dr. Nishant, absolutely right. Contradictory actions to contradictory intentions. Wow. You all are genius, I know. Because sir's teaching is always that sir says, think of thought process. So we are giving you a thought process of case taking. And according to that thought process, we are landing with the same medicines with the same result. Mahalakshmi, yes, suppress anger. That means suppress emotions and grief also. Absolutely fine. Sensitive to social position concern about, yes, we can think of. Always in a marital disharmony, there is a social position comes into picture. Absolutely right, Dr. Nanan. Anything else? So we will go further with the analytic process. So analysis, first and foremost, we have to understand the miasm. So miasm is psychosyphilis. So as fibroid is there, the miasm is psychosis is going to syphilis. AMH is low, which suggests that ovarian reserve or primary ovarian failure. This is syphilis. So we need to probe these things. We need to treat these things, syphilis, and we came back to the sora. Sora means the patient wants child. This is pregnancy is a sora, natural process. So analysis in a sora, the sensitive to criticism, sensitive to blame, sensitive to abuse, either mental, physical or verbal. Injustice cannot support but suffer silently. In psychosis, she goes to timidity. There is a will weak. There is a history of strong domination. She yielded to the domination. She is working, industrious, emotional reactions, weeping, grief, despair. Despair is psychosis, loss, bliss, fear of ghost and darkness. And in the syphilis, there is a very contradictions of it is autoimmune process. And another is the reactions that are very contradictory to intentions and actions. There is a physical sensitivity. We have a chili, thirstless, hunger aggravations, desire spices, especially chilies, aversion milk, sensitivity to riding and tight clothing, which aggravates. And the particular of the patient, physical particular of the patient, is quiescence, enjoyment, absence, and involuntary urination, sneezing, while. So this was just an analytical box of this case totality. Now, tell me, which remedy you are going to prescribe on this totality? Everyone is right. But this, on this basis of this totality, which remedy you are going to prescribe? Yes, Dr. Jidesh sir, Dr. Nishan, Dr. Chirag, Naitram or Sepia, yes, we can think of Imrana, Dr. Sepia or DD Corculus, yes, Anand Salia, very good, Sepia. Anything else, anyone? So this is what the exactly predictive homeopathy. You can predict from the analysis the right remedy and all are going to have the same remedy is Sepia. Exactly. So this is what a totality analysis. Low AMH is autoimmune process, abuse physically and mentally and sexually, reactions contrary to her intentions and history of strong dominations of in-laws. So I took three rubric as a main totality. Then I will give you another sectorial totality also. So in a three rubric, element from sexual abuse. This is something that when you, it is a sensitivity when you are treating a syphilitic case and when you are treating a psoriatic case, you can take element. So this is what we are thinking of. Element from sexual abuse. Second, the reaction contradictory, actions are contrary to intentions. And the third one is quiescence, enjoyment, absence. So we left with the two remedy, Sepia and Phosphorus. So absolutely all are right. It's a Sepia. The mental totality of this patient is will contradictions of, or Dr. Anand rightly said, is antagonism with self. These are the same rubric. Contradictory actions, contradictory to intentions, element from abuse, and the sensitivity to reproach. We have a Sepia and Aquanet. It is a mental totality. When we go to the physical general totality, that she had milk aversion and hunger aggravations. So in that also Sepia is there. And if we go to the particular totality of the case, female genitalia, quiescence, enjoyment absent, and involuntary urination, sneezing, aggravated. Again in that Sepia is the remedy. So this is what the Sepia is the case. We prescribe Sepia 30, TDS for 3 days, SL for 1 month. Sir always says, you are absolutely good at analysis and prescribing the remedy. But unless and until you get the follow-up, you are in the right direction or wrong direction. So this is what we are doing with the process. So after prescribing Sepia for Sepia 3 days and SL for 1 month, the patient came to me in the next month follow-up. She had no menses till 25th of Jan. She said, every time I used to have menses in the 20 days of span, but this time 1 month or 2 days pass, no menses comes. There is a body pain, pain in abdomen, stool, appetite was normal. So I advised UPT test and the UPT test came positive. So this is what the same remedy SL was prescribed for 1 month and advised antenatal USG after 20 days. So 15th of March 2017, the patient came with the reports and USG shows intrauterine single lac embryo with a 6 week, 2 days. So this was the report of 14th March 2017. The patient came to me on the 27th of Jan. And this is what the report shows. So, and also there is a tiny intramural fibroid. Even fibroid can reduce to a tiny things. So this is what in finance, sir always says, there is no money monopoly in incurable disease. So once you understand the fishing process, you can have the same infinite result with the homeopathy. And after the 5 months of the delivery, a patient came with the sweet box of sweet, and this was the baby boy. See the brightness on the face. So this is something which we are going to have with. Now, this was the case we are dealing with the sepia. So, today we are going to have an insight about the sepia in Materia Medica, a trimiasmatic aspect. So, everyone's favorite remedy, sepia. We are starting with the sepia succus, a cuttlefish. Actually, it is not fish, it is a mollusk. It is a mollusk. Look at the image of sepia. Introduction. The remedy name is Sepia officinalis. Animal kingdom mollusk. Class Cephalopoda. Order Dibranchiata. Family Sepidae. Common name cuttlefish. So to understand cuttlefish, and the remedy prepared from the cuttlefish, Zahneman beautifully mentioned in a chronic disease, they use a trituration of the dry black liquid contained in the ink bag of the mollusk. So let's see what is cuttlefish is about. So I will share with you a video of cuttlefish.
Here are true facts about the cuttlefish. The cuttlefish is not a fish. It is a mollusk of the class Cephalopoda. The cuttlefish is a bit like a clam that millions of years ago came out of its shell and never went back. In fact, it still has a specialized shell, but on its inside, which is used for buoyancy and is called the cuttle bone. People for a long time have used this shell to carve casts for metal jewelry. These people are called cuttleboners, by me, and now by you. To move through the ocean, the cuttlefish has a wavy, wavy fin that surrounds its mantle. It also has a siphon, a muscular tube it can squirt water out of for fast propulsion. Imagine trying to move by vomiting out of a giant straw and flapping your skirt around very, very fast. That is how a cuttlefish do. The cuttlefish brain is larger than its entire body, including its brain, which may not make sense, but it does to the cuttlefish because it has a very large brain. The cuttlefish has a very advanced eye, roughly in the shape of Charlie Brown's mouth when he misses a football, or perhaps a W that someone wrote when they were drunk, or the letter Q that someone wrote when they were really drunk. Despite its big brain and weird eyes, the cuttlefish is colorblind, which is curious because it is a color magician of the deep. Like a lactose intolerant cheesemaker, the cuttlefish is unaware of its own gifts. With the help of millions of color changey things in its skin, it can change color and texture almost instantaneously. Playing hide and seek with a cuttlefish sucks. They don't move, they just change color. You can hear them breathing while you count. How the cuttlefish determines the backgrounds it blends into is largely a mystery, because it can do it in complete darkness, which is kind of a dumb gift if you ask me, but still amazing. Ah, fish! Then there's the flamboyant cuttlefish, which doesn't try to blend in with shit. It just says, why doesn't the world try to blend in with me? You go, little man. Don't go changing for nobody. When it is threatened, the cuttlefish will often release ink from its ink sac. The cuttlefish releases that ink in one of two ways. One is a little piffing sort of squirt, something you might say excuse me after. The second is a release of both ink and mucus. More of a throw your underwear out and go home early sort of inking. These are called pseudomorphs and are designed to be decoys for the cuttlefish as it escapes. The cuttlefish feeds by extending two hidden feeding tentacles, which it uses to snag prey and pull it back towards its poison beak. What? Well, apparently it has a beak. Very slowly it extends. The fish just had to move like 2 inches. Cuttlefish mating begins when the male delicately grabs the female by the face and inserts another specialized tentacle into an opening near her mouth, which I hope is not her nose, and inserts sperm sacs. Males have 4 pairs of arms and females have 3. Weaker males often disguise themselves as females by hiding 2 of their arms. This reminds me of what I may or may not have done in the mirror as a young boy. These cleverly disguised males swim right past the competition and do the face sex thing. After the female eggs are fertilized, she gingerly and lovingly puts her eggs in some random friggin' hole on the bottom of the ocean. The eggs are called sea grapes by people who like shitty wine, and they are guarded by the couple until they hatch into the cutest little freaks in the universe. These little babies are not so good at the camouflage, but they do the best that they can. Cover yourself up, little man, and sleep tight. Remember, if you ever want to come out of your shell and let your freak flag fly, the cuttlefish has your...
So, you all have a good idea about the cuttlefish, the quality of the cuttlefish, and is the basic natures of the fish animal. So the few highlighting point is the eye. The cuttlefish have a large pupil with a W-shaped 8 arms and 2 tentacles furnished with the denticulate suckers. They secure their prey and they are soft-bodied animal without spine. So eye is so much so advanced and sophisticated. The eye of cuttlefish is very unique and they have a smooth W-shaped pupil. The eye appears half closed as if drunken. Although cuttlefish cannot see colors, they can perceive the polarization of the light, which enhances their perception of the contrast. So by looking at this process, we can think that the sensitivity of the sepia female is, I don't want to see the world as it hurts me. Very. So, due to this sensitivity, she had reactions, and reaction at the physical level, it is something like eye close with sadness. The remedy is argentum nitricum and sepia. And you all have the dullness, drooping and falling of the leaves is also a sepia. This is the ptosis. Surrogate hurts goes into psychosis. Eye falling. I don't want to see the world as it hurts. And due to this eye, as if it is half closed or drunken, so mostly the rubric we found in an observatory, in a case taking, that when you are questioning the sepia patient, and sepia patient is frivolously close the eyes when questions like this, very slowly and answering. Or when she is talking something, she close eyes. So we have a 2 rubric. Eye closed frivolously on being questioned. The only remedy is sepia. And another rubric is eye closed, closing desire to when talk to. So when someone is talking with you and they are trying to talk with you during case checking, you can directly think of sepia. Are you getting me? Hope you are getting me. Again, the eye component, cuttlefish cannot see colors. So they have see black and white pictures. They cannot see colors. So, what is happening? I will share you Sir's case from webinar. Sir has beautifully mentioned it in the webinars that a 26-year-old female married 6 months back got hurt on the right eye while traveling in the bus, met with an accident. After a few days, a swelling reduced, but she started seeing everything blurred, followed by colorless vision on the right eye. Everything appears black and white. Eye specialist went on diagnosis her as multiple sclerosis. That patient's sister was working with the sir as assistant in the clinic, and she asked sir for the help. Sir asked her whether she had talked to her sister about any marital disharmony or problem recently. Assistant doctor said, "No, sir, she has no problem and she is very happy about her married life," was the answer. How sir beautifully analyzed this case, that the right-sided injury means there is a problem with the husband or in-laws or a workplace. And colorless vision. So colorless vision indicate that she has lost interest in life. Her life has no color left. It is just black and white. Life is not interesting. She has developed indifferent to life. This is exactly what sepia color means. So this could mean that so early in her married life, she had realized that this marriage was a mistake and she has been mentally hurt, driving her to levotropy by secretion of the epinephrine or norepinephrine. The only reason probably of going into such a state immediately after marriage is that she has come to know that the husband loved someone else and still loved some other lady. So this was sir's conclusion, and sir told assistant doctor to confirm it by ringing her in front of sir. And she obliged. When confronted, she broke down and started weeping on a phone and said that the situation is that, like sir has predicted, was exactly the same. And she had no interest in her life, left in her life. So this was the predictive homeopathy is. Sir always says, anything happen in your body or your circumstances, nothing happen without the cause. So there is something a cause. So sir is finding out the cause. So sir gave one dose of sepia 10 mg and her vision completely recovered to the normal. So what sir said, in such condition, not only the mind of the patient improves, but also the environment and the circumstances that lead to the delirious conditions is bound to change. For example, improvement of the patient conditions is accompanied by improvement in the relationship with the people around, in a bargain, even extramarital affair comes to an end. So this is what something happening with the positronic effect of our homeopathic medicines, that it can transform levotropy to normotropy or dextrotropy. I will explain levotropy in a later slide. Don't worry. This was sir's case. Sir has prescribed 10 mg because there is a physiological change. Okay. That's why sir has given. So further going into the sepia study, this was the color blindness. Cuttlefish are amongst the most intelligent invertebrate, as we saw it in a video, and having the largest brain to body size ratio. And large brain is a sharp, intelligent, keen senses, one of the clever denizens of the seas. So see that there is a sensory organ, brain, stella, ganglion, chromatophores. Chromatophores help to change their colors in the environment. So cuttlefish is always there to change their and mix with the environment. They are changing to the environment because of ascapic natures. And there is a large brain. Large brain signifies they are very intellectual. But when they go into syphilitic state, their intellectual become dull. They become indolent and everything. Again, we saw the king of camouflage, the master of disguise, and chameleon to see in the video. Though cuttlefish has many defense, and it is the most impressive of this is ability to rapidly change the color, pattern, shape, and textures of their skin as it and its will also. This skill can be used to hide them from the sight, but they can also use to make themselves exceptionally visible also. Cuttlefish is a master of illusions, changing its color and shape in a blinks of an eye. There is no limit to colors it can display on the skin, hypnotizing its prey and even become invisible. Every place they go, they are morphing into something that looks like their environment. Their ability to change color, shape, pattern is to camouflage themselves. It is the basic of attack defense to warn of potential predators and a wondrous system of communications. Again, when we think of melanin and pigment, we can think of mollusk, cephalopod, sepia. So cephalopod mollusk has an ink sac that produces a defensive cephalopod ink. The ink sac is used to expel a cloud of dark ink in order to confuse predator. And it contains almost pure melanin. So the ejected cloud of melanin is formed by mucus particles. So it is formed a lump approximately the size and shape of the cephalopods, fixing the predator's attentions while the mollusk itself makes a hasty escape. Exactly what we saw in a video that she threw the ink and she went away. So this is what something. And it contained a pure melanin. So when it contained a pure melanin, so it signifies that it actions on the melanocytes. So we have a rubric in our materia medica that face cloasma. We have a sepia, face cloasma in a pregnancy, face yellow spot cloasma gravidarum, sepia Lycopodium laxomica, face brown spot leucorrhea which Colophyllum natrum and sepia. Sir, explain in modern homeopathy and homeopathy in modern science that pigment proteins, when there is a pigment proteins is affected, it can lead to either a psychosis, lead to depositions of the pigment, or in a syphilis, it can destructions of the pigment. So when we think of indifferent to life, indifferent to color of the life, then we have the presentations on the skin is vitiligo. The skin become white. And when there is an insecurity in the relationship, there is a depositions of the pigment, and that makes the cloasma. So this is what melanin and pigment about. Sphere of actions, it acts on the venous circular digestive tract, portal system and female pelvic organ, act on the nerves, skins and left sided. Physical constitutions, we read everything from the Kent Materia Medica and many Materia Medica, we say the sepia is predominantly a woman's remedy. But it is not so. It can be used in male also. We can think of physical constitutions when the person of a dark hair, rigid fiber, but mild and easy disposition. Pot-bellied mothers. The mother who have many pregnancy. This is sepia. Yellow saddle across the nose. Irritable. Who faint from the least exertions. Leucophlegmatic constitutions. Sir beautifully explained that face changing colors or dark circle under the eyes. When you see the constitution face changing colors, you can think of sepia. Cloasma, I beautifully explained. Saddle like brownish distributions on the nose, cheek, butterfly pigmentations. Swollen, cracked lower lip. Old wrinkled with spots, telltale face. This was the physical constitution. See, when we are dealing with the case taking, we are observing the patients by just physical constitution. So when you find this point in the physical constitution, you can directly think of sepia. Ailment from. So there is a psoric ailment, psychotic ailment and syphilitic ailment. So in a psora, the ailment from anticipation, forwarding, excitement, emotionals and ailment from the work mental. So when this goes into chronicity, there is anger suppressed, anger vexations, anger anxiety with, from anger fright with, business failure, debauchery, disappointment, deception, love disappointment, jealousy, mortifications, being scorned, and element from sexual excess. And finally, in syphilis, they have element from embarrassment and fright. So these are the elements can cause psychosis, psora or syphilitic disease starting point. Modality, being a chilly remedy, aggravation from the cold, air, snowfall, wet, sexual excess, before menses, pregnancy, abortions, before thunderstorm and washing clothes. Being a washerwoman remedy, washing clothes aggravates. emulation from the violent motions, dancing. So we have a rubric, dyspnea emulated by dancing. So whenever you find, we usually ask the patient in Gujarat, how was your energy during Garba in Navratri season? So when patient says that, husband says that, sir, काम में इतनी थक जाती है पर जब नवरात्रि आती है तो 9 दिन इतना डांस करती है, इतना गरबा खेलती है, पता ही नहीं चलता, उसको थकान ही नहीं लगती. दैट वाज द सिचुएशन. यू कैन थिंक ऑफ सेपिया, डांसिंग डिजायर फॉर डांसिंग एमुलेट्स. व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ डांसिंग डिजायर फॉर, वी हैव अ कार्सिनोसिन, देयर इज अ ग्रेसफुल डांसर्स. व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ डांसिंग, वी कैन थिंक ऑफ टेरेंट्यूला एंड क्यूबेंसिस. Tarantula, Hispanica has a chaotic dance, Cubensis has a little bit of rhythmic dance. So this is what has little bit differentiations of Sepia, Tarantula and Carcinosa. Evolution from violent motions, warmth of bed, pressure, hot application, crossing or drawing limbs up after sleep, cold drinks, cold bath and open air. Physical generals, appetite voracious, appetite or no appetite, sudden craving, suddenly satiety. Thirstless, craving for vinegar, acids, pickles, sweets, aversion to meat, bread, salt, fatty rich foods, thermally chilly. So now we go to the dispositions of the sepia. How sepia present to us in a dispositions level? So sir has beautifully explained the disposition. You can think of disposition in the following criteria: extroverted, introverted, will, intellect, moral, sensitivity, attachment, and reaction. So in that case, we have divided the quality of the sepia. So sepia is basically introverted remedy. There is a talk indisposed to, though it is there in a vivacious also, she can be friendly with everyone, but nobody will know her inner feeling. She would share only to close ones like natrum, because sepia is complementary to natrum. So natrum can go into state of sepia also. Basically, they are introverted. Will, she is mild, timid, and introverted. She appears to be weak will, but due to that, there is a large brain and a good intellect. She is a very strong person and lot of inner strength and very, very positive person. Again, sir said that sepia is positive, but sepia is negatively positive. So, in their negative situation, also she goes into positive way. This is what negatively positive is. Independent females, one can think of sepia in female who are mentally strong, don't break down in a crisis. They keep doing their duties without any show off. So this is what, when we think of this point, independent and don't break in a crisis, and they are duty bound without show off, you can directly think of aurum metallicum. So when you think of aurum mat and sepia, aurum mat, you can also think the sepia is like same. Okay, intellect is very good, moral good, very conscientious person. She is duty conscience, who continue work for her family in spite of not liking every work she is doing, and finally end up with the despair about miserable existence of the self. This is what a good moral remedy. Sensitivity, the sensitive person who get offended easily, she takes everything in bad part like lilium tea. Every little advice or every little criticism takes into bad part, lilium tea. Same like sepia, she takes everything in a bad part. She is sensitive towards her family, doing all her duties toward them. As she does not get the proper response from them, she feels bad, and her reaction is that of indifferent towards everybody. So finally, sensitivity lead to indifference. Sensitivity increase before menses. She is sensitive to music too, especially piano playing. She is averse to music and piano playing. She is sensitive towards noise and odor too. And the reactions. The sepia always reactions is indifference. She goes very easily into state of indifference. So this was the basic reactions of the sepia. Now, this was just the basic dispositions of the sepia. How to identify sepia in today's world? So we will go to the entry point of the sepia. So as I mentioned that the sepia is very positive persons, a will strong persons, independent female, career oriented females, and who is rebellious. When you think of this five quality, you can think of some metal remedy. Because like all metals, they are strong will, independent, career oriented, achievers, and rebellious kind of personality and having a positivity. When you find some metal remedy, think of sepia also along with them. So these are the few entry point in today's world. Female who is not so concerned about her looks and appearance. Very important aspect. Nowadays, the female is beauty conscious. But when you think a simple, sober female, not so much concerned about their looks and appearance, you can directly think of sepia. Because sepia easily goes into state of indifference. So there is no interest of beautifications. Female who does not like to dress up or does not like to wear makeup or jewelry. Same as, whereas Lachesis and Conine likes to dress up the best and the jewelries. Who usually wear dull colored and simple dressed. Female with not so girly or feminine looks. Lean, thin female with a narrow pelvis, yellow saddle across upper part of the cheek and nose and the tilt and face. So when you look at the whole phenomena of these symptoms, you can think of confusion, identity from feminine to masculine. So when you think of a man's kind of woman, when you think of there is a feminine pair qualities lack of due to disturbances of the hormonal issues leading to masculine and they having a narrow pelvis, narrow chest and lean and thin people, so you can directly think of sepia. There is a narrow chest. What is the chest represent? Chest and breast represent nurturing. Sepia don't want to nurture. See, you have seen beautifully in the video also. When sepia lays the egg, cuttlefish lays the eggs, the cuttlefish male and female dies before the eggs hatches into born of that child sepia. So the child is like devoid of love. She is not taking care of everything. So this is what she usually goes into indifference. That is why she has no nurturing. So always we have seen that flat chested, narrow chested or a male like pelvis like a female. So this is what sepia is. Sepia is reserved, introverted, not expressive, who does not like consolations, who prefer to be alone, does not like company, very industrious person, but having miserly patience. So sepia is very money minded, like Lycopodium. Like Pulsatilla, indifferent person to loved one. This is syphilitic state of sepia. When finally we end up with the syphilitic state, they directly go into indifferent state. And indifference to loved ones, indifference to family, indifference to domestic duty. There is no interest in anything. She likes physical exercise. She likes gymming. She likes physical exercise. She likes dancing. She likes garba and everything, and having history of suppress by dominating parents. When you think of this personality comes to you, those who are dominated by parents and goes into indifferent state, like dancing, like physical exercise, you can think of. There is a strong domination in carcinosin also. But what carcinosin more to them, carcinosin up to the level of artistic aptitude, and carcinosin does not go into indifferent state. She yield to everything. The reaction of the sepia to rudeness and domination will be complete introvertedness, loses internal emotions and finally become indifferent. Very sharp and critical by nature, and they are not the one who will complain about the parent. So sepia will never complain about the parents. There is no fear but wants security, because sepia has fear of poverty and the fear of ghost. So this is what they want, security. Security by means of money. Emotionally very dry and not sensitive. Sepia often start with the grief, becoming unhappy, ailment after grief, ailment after death of near ones. Because of this grief, they resign, become indifferent and apathetic, but it has to express somewhere on the skin as melasma, cloasma, or a vitiligo. So this is what a brutal separation can lead to vitiligo also. She is quite reserved, indifferent, no attachment to family and friends. Like fluoric acid, CPI has no attachment to family and friends. Okay? They are very sarcastic. Stasis inside. In a psychosis, everything goes inside. She suffers silently. The need of the CPI is esteem. She is vivacious, intellectual and linguistic mind, calculative mind. Want to give up the responsibility. Physical entry point. Vijaykar sir always use this keynote of prescribing the sepia. It should be given as an antidote to patient when patient go on in dull, indifferent state after a wrong homeopathic medicine. Sir is beautifully explaining theory of acute bone sepia. Sir, quote that structural process cannot be antidoted by sepia. Sepia will work only on physiological cases. Note this point. Very important point. Sepia, when there is someone is going into dullness after homeopathic medicines, sepia will work only on physiological level, not on structural process. So sepia removes the bad effects. Sepia removes the bad effect of the homeopathic medicine. Hence, sepia is given if the case is going in a wrong direction to antidote the case. Sepia can antidote the bad effect of X-ray, radiations, and electric shock also. If patient goes into sadness, depressions after electric shock, thunderstorm, sonography. Sonography is also high frequency sound waves and can injure sensitive patient. So when you find someone going to X-ray and radiation and finally they become dull, indolent, indifferent state, you can think of sepia because it is a physiological in nature. So it removes the bad effect. So from Sir's clinical tips, Sir's case, Sir got a phone call at one night saying that my child whose cough I took medicine 2 days now suffering from the breathlessness. Should I take her for nebulization in hospital? Sir said, no, just give her a dose of sepia 200 and she should be fine. And sepia would work miracle. Second case, patient says, my child having fever for last 8 days. I tried homeopathy in local homeopathy clinic. He changed many medicines, but with every new medicines, my child got high fever. Now he told me to go and take allopathy. What should I do? This was the patient's question. Sir replied, without taking any history, sir gave him a sepia 200 and it would be angel remedy by which the cure with the ease. So sir's clinical tips is this rubric, fever, heat, changing, paroxysm, homeopathic potencies after suppressions by. The sepia is the only remedy. So when you find a person going into dull state, from this point of view, sir has given us insight in the COVID situations also that in the first stage of the COVID, when you find the persons become dull without any symptoms of the pneumonia and everything, and a person become indolent, sad, dull, indifference, first remedy to be prescribed is sepia. Because there is nothing happening without the cause. So Organon has mentioned the cause, beautiful cause is like it is a physical cause, physiological cause, psychological or emotional cause, and there is a telluric or meteoric cause. So when there is a change in the electromagnetic field or electrical field or radiation or electrical shock, you can think of sepia by using this rubric. So sir has said that many of the persons are negated, many of the list of imbedrula that can be negated by the sepia. Like when you use misuse of homeopathic potency, you can use sepia to antidote. When there is an electric shock, you can use sepia to antidote. When there is a change in the electromagnetic waves X-rays, Reiki effect. There is an effect of Reiki. You can use sepia to antidote that. Disturbed vibration of environment, bad effect of stone in the rings, tavis, locket, etc. When you use this, when someone is using this and they become dull after that, wearing the tavis or wearing the stone in the rings and everything, you can antidote with the sepia. Sir always says that all Reiki masters suffer from autoimmune disease, means epilysis, because a lot of negative charges from the different people came to them. So in a most of Reiki master, you can think of sepia. So in above cases, patient might not be a constitutionally sepia patient, but they can go into sepia, like natrum ura, natrum cap turn into sepia because of introvertedness, ignition turn into sepia because of limb conscientious type, well, pulsatility turn into sepia because of weeping, yelling type, lux vomica turn into sepia, irritable ST achiever, lycopodium also turn into sepia, dictator leader type. Sulfur also can turn into sepia, philosopher. Calicarb and causticum turn into sepia because of quarrelsome and litigiousness. And carcinosin, those who have been dominated by others for a long time, they can also turn into sepia. Because constitutionally they are not sepia, but they can turn from carcinosin to sepia, calicarb to sepia, sulfur to sepia, and lots of. So this is what we are thinking of. Another point. The first point we thought is changing the vibrations, bad effect of vibrations and everything. Another point, whenever you find any lesion, anywhere, even in any reports, which signifies round, circular, ring-like lesion, think of sepia, nothing. This is what serves beautiful explanations. I will show you the rubric, which rubric is used in this case. So when you find this round circular ring like lesion anywhere, any pathology or any reports, you can just think of sepia. Look at this image. There is a ring like structure in the brain scan. And when you think this, see, disease, sir always says, no matter the name of the disease itself is, we just need to treat the process of the patients, process of the miasm. When you find the process of miasm in a round circular ring like, you can think of sepia. So I consult a radiologist, and in a radiology, I found that ring lesion or pathology in a ring form is equal to sepia. Note this point. When you find MR imaging or any radiological features, in that case, when you find a ring-like lesion, either a complete or an incomplete ring, you can think of following diagnosis by radiological means. So when you find a cerebral abscess, it is also ring-like lesion. Tuberculoma, it's a ring-like. Neurocysticercosis, metastasis of the cancer or glioblastoma, subacute infarct, hemorrhage or contusions, demyelinations, it is a complete or incomplete ring. Tumefactive demyelinations lesion, complete or incomplete. Radiation necrosis. When you find radiation necrosis, when the person having a brain tumor is not operated and it can be given radiations and finally turns into radiation necrosis. And that necrosis leading to ring-like lesion. See, every cell has their actions. So when the cell is in a very what we call as a sober way or a fastidious way. Sir always says, cancer in a fastidious state or a fastidious way, it is ascending. When you think cancer in a ring like, sepia. This is what radiation necrosis. Lymphoma, leukemia, thrombosis, aneurysm, necrotizing, leukoencephalopathy after methotrexate. So all this lead to, there is a brain scan, and in brain scan you can find this lesion. So the case one, abscess. The brain lesion ring-like, case 2, the metastasis, case 3, ADM, acute demyelinations, ring-like lesion, glioblastoma multiforming, ring-like lesion, stroke, ring-like lesion, radionecrosis, ring-like lesion, glioblastoma multiforma, and the tuberculoma. Look at this small area here. That is suggestive of tuberculoma. So when you find any ring circular like a lesion in your scan, just think of sepia. Why I am probing in this? Because I am showing you a two case. One is a bigger case and one is an acute case. And in both cases, Sapir does wonders. So, sharing with the case of cholangiocarcinoma liver. This was a case of my mentor, Dr. Jitesh sir. And Jitesh sir has beautifully treated this case. You can see the scan of this patient. In the right, it is a scan is enlarged. And you can see the ring-like cholangiocarcinomatous lesion in a yellow circle. By looking at this and the history of the patients, Jitesh sir prescribed Sapir. See, look at the CA19.9 report, tumor marker on the 3rd September 2021. CA19.9 is more than 10,000 IU. After prescribing Sapir, in a one month or 2 months of span on the 24th November, follow of CA19.9 is 1200 IU. This is what we call as Sapir does wonders. So this is what report enclosed. This was in a right side, the report was a previous report more than 10,000. And in a left side, the report of the follow-up 1,200. So this signifies that the Sapir is beautifully acted in ring-like lesion. Hope you got this point. Are you getting me? I will show you another case of my acute OPD. The female patient came with a skin lesion and the past history of a female patient came with a skin lesion. I will show you lesion in a photograph. The past history is the tuberculosis and she is lean and thin. So this was the lesion. The left side image shows that a ring-like lesion of eruption. It can be a fungal infection, it can be a nummular eczema, it can be any disease name it may be. When you find something in a ring-like lesion, you can think of Sapir. On the basis of this ring-like lesion, I prescribed Sapir 200 single dose. Within a week follow-up, she came with the right-sided image. That image shows every lesion gone. So the rubric for above case is this. Sir has clinically used this rubric in many cases. Cancerous affection, lupus, carcinomatous in rings, the only remedy is Sapir. In clinical, tuberculosis, lupus vulgaris, ring in Sapir. So when you find any pathological process, either cancer, either tuberculosis, either indurations, either proliferations, either destructions, or either cavity formations in a ring format, you can just prescribe Sapir on the basis of this phenomenon. Hope you got this. Those who cannot, again, we will go to the physical point of, I will discuss the queries in the last session, in end of sessions. Yes, you can think of in a ringworm also. There is a rubric, trichophytosis in spots. Trichophytosis in spot, you can have only remedy Sapir. Those who cannot bear smell of tobacco or smoking, you can think of Sapir. Sapir has anxiety, which makes him walk rapidly. For those who like to walk, exert, exercise, love sports and dancing, you can think of Sapir. Those who hate sympathy, support, consolations and contradictions and are very independent on themselves, they are Sapir. Sir says most of politicians could be Sapir because they have no attachment, no emotions. Politicians, they just wanted to do their work. Sir's entry points. Think of Sapir when patient came with the following part affections. So In the same way, you can think of occiput. Occiput is a region. You know, phrenology, sir, beautifully explained that occiput is region, signifies family and loved ones. So when there is an issue or a conflict with the family and loved ones, there may be many of the disease happening in the body. But occiput is a region, signifies. That's location, signifies. So when you find headache, especially in occiput area, if urine is delayed, you can think of sepsis. Like gelsemia, headache ameliorated by urination. Same like in sepsis. If urine is delayed, there is a headache in occipital area. When you find dandruff, psoriasis, itching, eruption, especially on occipital area, you can think of sepsis. Very easy. When you find heat, congestions, chilliness in occipital area, think of sepsis. When you find emptiness, happiness, heaviness, formications in occipital area, think of sepsis. Why? Because these all diseases are associated with the conflict with the family and loved ones. So, for example, dandruff, psoriasis, itch, eruptions are associated with the separation conflict or wanting to separate from the loved one. So, they goes into indifferent state. Okay, so this is what something signifies. When you find the lesion in the occipital area affected, you can think of sepsis. Another important point is when you find cracks, itching, excoriation, swelling, and bleeding, especially from the nipple and mame, this also signifies sepsis. What is a nipple and mame signifies? I beautifully explained in narrow chested again to previous slide that nipple and mame signifies the nutrients. And if she goes into syphilitic state, in a psoriatic state, she is very anxious mother and she is very anxious about their children. But when they goes into syphilitic state, she has aversion to children, aversion to loved one, aversion to families and everything. So this aversion to children and families and everything leading to syphilitic process at the level of locations, specifically nipple and mame. And when you find these cracks, itching, excoriations, swelling, bleeding at nipple and mame, just think of sepsis. Sex. Very important aspect of sepsis is sex. So when you find sex is a scene or something called as sepsis doesn't like to have a sex, then there are certain phenomena happening in the sepsis constitutions, specifically confusion after sex, dullness after sex, discourage after sex, indifferent apathy after sex, headache, occiput after sex, frustration of mind after sex, vertigo after sex, faintness, physical relaxations, weakness after sex. When you find any of these complaints after sex, think of sepsis. She had strong aversion to coition. So aversion to coitions from fear of increasing the family, aversion to coitions from vaginismus, aversion to coitions from pains in vagina, aversion to coitions from sore pain in the uterus. Even thinking of coitions makes her nausea. Very important. So this is a strong aversion to coitions. Male, in a male, when you find itching, penis during coitions, only remedy is sepsis. And ejaculation too short and too quick, you can think of sepsis and netrangle. So when a constitution or a person refused to conjugal coition, you can think of this remedy. Onan, likewise, sepsis. Are you getting me? Very important aspect of sepsis. Now, when things grow wrong in life, direction changes to liver trophy. Very important. I will explain this liver trophy right now because it is in the same previous slide. When things go wrong in the life, direction changes to liver trophy. It causing dullness, indifferent, indolence, in losing interest in life, apathy, and move toward death. Means the life is count anti-clockwise. Life is going anti-clockwise. You can think of sepia. So that means indifferent and apathy, indifferent to children, indifferent to loved ones, indifferent to family, indifferent to life, indifferent to business, indifferent to pleasure, indifferent to questions, indifferent to duties of himself, indifferent to domestic duties. When you find a person with this lot of indifference, you can think of sepia because they goes into liver toxin. Life means working, life means enjoying, but here they don't want to exist. So they goes into liver toxin. So what is the meaning of dextro to liver toxin? So, sir has beautifully explained in the webinar last year in COVID that we shall get answer of understanding in autonomic nervous system by extra to levotrophy. So, we have to understand what is autonomic nervous system is. So, the sepia has a specific affinity on autonomic nervous system. In our previous slide, regional sphere of action, we find the axonal nerves. So, sepia has action on the six-layer nervous system. The nervous system comprises of two components, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Again, peripheral nervous system comprising of two systems, autonomic nervous system and somatic nervous system. So, autonomic nervous system has two components, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. So, what is sympathetic? Sympathetic has accelerated everything. It helps in the fight and flight response. Whereas, parasympathetic slowed down and breaking of the systems, improving the digestions and everything. You can read sympathetic and parasympathetic from the medicine book. I am just giving you a glimpse of this. So when a person's by means of any bad vibrations, by means of any physiological or emotional trauma, they goes into stimulations of the parasympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system slowed down, going into secretion of epinephrine and norepinephrine, leading to state of indifferent, dullness, indolence, and everything, you can think of sepia. This is called levotrophy. It was going toward death. So when sepia slow down, indifferent, and you calm down and slow down of the parasympathetic system. When the parasympathetic system being calmed down and slow down, there is emptiness feeling in the body. There is all gone sensation in the body. The person having the tendency to faint. The blood pressure is lowering. Blood sugar is lowering, leading to syncope and vertigo. So this is what a sepia is. Now vertigo. So what is vertigo? So when the parasympathetic nervous system is activated or stimulated by means of any cause, the vertigo with loss of consciousness, you can think of sepia. Vertigo tendency to fall during fever. The only remedy is sepia. Sir has beautifully mentioned it in the books also. Old people tend to become drowsy and unsteady in fever or eyelid fall during fever. Think of two remedies, gelsemium and sepia. Vertigo on shaking head quickly. This also stimulates the vagus now and leading to vertigo, vasovagal stimulations and leading to vertigo. Those who cannot exercise or even yoga, those who cannot tolerate exercise or even yoga, think of sepia. Are you getting me? Because sepia loves exercise but cannot tolerate exercise, think of sepia. Because of this, the parasympathetic nervous is hyperactivated and leading to this vertigo and everything and imbalance. When you think vertigo, the only remedy sepia in following rubric that vertigo when blowing the nose. When are you blowing the nose? Why vertigo is happened? Because when you're blowing the nose, there is a stimulation of vasovagal system and vasovagal system leading to vertigo. Sepia is the remedy. Vertigo with loss of consciousness, sepia is the remedy. Vertigo with tendency to fall, especially during fever, the only remedy is sepia. And the tendency to syncope. Patient aata hai, sir, mera BP bahut kam ho jata hai, BP low ho jata hai, har bar chakkar aake gir jati ho, kahin na kahin ho jata hai. When you find this type of lady, you can think of sepia. So where I go specifically after questions, after emissions, after stool, after diarrhea, after hemorrhage, after loss of fluid, after emotions. So when you find any unnatural discharge which leading to vertigo, think of CPAP. After all unnatural discharge, think of CPAP. Vertigo on stooping or after eating. See, the image shows that when you stoop there, it stimulates the vasovagal center, and vertigo stimulates the vasovagal center and causing nausea. So when you find something with the nausea also, you can think of CPAP. So we will go with the nausea. So when nausea after eating, because after eating there is a simulations of the pneumogastric nerve producing vasovagal affections. Nausea after eye strain. Again, eye strain goes to stimulate the vagus nerve. Loss of vision, blindness, nausea during. Nausea disturb the sleep. Nausea entering into warm room. Again, it is a warm room climate. Bed vibration changes the or stimulate the parasympathetic nervous system. So nausea. Nausea riding carriage. Nausea ringing the mouth. And nausea smoking aggravated. When you find this particular in a certain patient, you can think of CPAP. Now we have a following few guiding symptoms. Few guiding symptoms of CPAP. Sensation of ball in inner part or pain moves upward. This is something hysterical kind of CPAP sensations. Bearing down pains of the great intensity in abdomen and back. Bearing down aggravated in standing or walking. Bearing down extend into thighs. So she must have to cross the limbs and prevent the prolapse. Again, due to the looseness and laxity of the musculature systems, there is a tendency to abortion, especially at the 5th and 7th month when the child is enlarging and she cannot hold the child. So it can abort it at later month of 5th or 7th. Empty all gone sensation, as I explained beautifully in the vasovagal process. Nausea from the smell of the cooking food, sight, thought of food, everything. Irregular menses of every form. When the lady came to you with the all hormonal issues, first think of CPAP. Because CPAP is a hormone regulator. When there is a stasis of hormone, it can stimulate the hormone and it regulates the hormone. So CPAP is a hormone regulator. Flushes of the heat, epilation, flushes and the sweats, all is because of hyperstimulations of the parasympathetic activity. Dyspnea relieved by dancing and walking rapidly. Violent exercise ameliorate, chilly, thirstless, lopsided, pain in complaint travel upwards, and conjunctivitis inflammation is of sluggish type. It is a chronic. So now this was just a few guiding symptoms of the CPAP at physical level. We go previously we had took disposition of the CPAP. Now how CPAP is presented to us miasmatically in psora, psychosis and syphilis. So we are starting with the psora. I will take a second break of water. So, how CPAP present to us in a psora? So, CPAP in psora is excitable, nervous, fidgety, and very sensitive remedy. There is the extreme irritability of the mind as well as the tissue. Delicate female with a fine skin, sensitive to all impressions. They are aggravated by noise, excitement, and company. They are sensitive to criticism. They are sensitive to contradictions. So in a psora, they are quiet. They do not talk much. They are quiet and introverted. They may be timid. However, they may be very active. They need to work all the time and keep themselves busy. They are better. All complaints are better when they are occupied. They are very careful people. They need everything to be neat and proper, spikes and span. They cannot tolerate any dirt and untidiness. That's why Sepia is called as washerwoman remedy. She wants to clean everything. In spite of clean clothes, she usually washes the clothes again and again and again because they feel that they don't tolerate dirt and untidiness. They are very sensitive and easily offended. They are hurt and feel bad easily. There is irritability with any offense. Sensitive to all mental impressions like light, music, cannot tolerate music at all, noise, even slightest noise, even voice. Sensitive to odor, especially cooking food. Very sensitive to pain. Sensitive to sensual impressions and very sentimental in Sora. Anxiety is a hallmark of the Sepia and it complains coming from the anticipations. So there is a stage fright. She is very much anxious about her children. And there is anxiety during climatic period. Very anxiety, anxious during fever also. Anxiety future about, anxiety health about, anxiety with the headache, anxiety looking steadily, anxiety from exertion of the eyes. So there is a lot of anxiety with the physical complaint, like a vertigo, pain, nausea, abdominal pain, riding aggravates, and anxiety after vaccinations. Thus, everything, anxiety about little things, little complaint, which explain anxiety about trifles. So there is anxiety about trifles, anxiety well alone, and there is anxiety while walking, which makes him walk faster. Sepia is very sensitive remedy in Sora. They cannot tolerate any kind of contradictions. Even cannot tolerate consolations either. She does not share with problem with anybody. In fact, narrating her symptoms actually aggravate her complaint. She feels there is no use of sharing her problem. She hates people sympathizing with her, asking her about her conditions or consoling and feeding her in any way. This is exactly opposite to Pulsatilla. Exactly opposite to Tarantula. Tarantula and Pulsatilla want to show the sickness, wants pity, wants consolations and everything. Whereas Sepia hates their things. Sepia hates sympathizing others. Whereas Pulsatilla wants sympathy from others. It makes her irritable and angry. And she is very easily offended, vexed, and disposed to scold. In Sora and Psychosis, Sepia is hardworking woman or man and better when occupied and doing their work. There is anxiety about business. There is like lots of anxiety about futures and anxiety about the money matters, especially about the futures. So they are more of anxious, but they are courageous people. They are positive and overcome any difficulty and go ahead. These are the Sepia. Many hurdles in life, they can pass and they go ahead. They are very intelligent and there is an active thinking of mind. They theorize a lot in Psychosis like sulfur and having lots of ideas. When you find a positive, industrial, strong woman who cannot tolerate any kind of injustice and will stand up to fight for their rights, especially for the right of the others, we call it a woman empowerment. And there is a woman empowerment organizations or woman welfare organizations. When you find some such kind of people who are very strongly a woman and could be a part of women's organization and for the women's liberations, they cannot tolerate any kind of injustice and they fight for others. This is Sepia. So Soric element, so Sepia is esteem remedy. So they are sensitive to being scorned, sensitive to being strong domination by the parents and bad effect of the strong dominations. There is always a traumatic childhood. The child's mind has been exposed to the excessive trauma and that is not good for upbringing. This creates a bad memory of the past and the child loses his or her childhood and premature sensitiveness gradually develops as a secondary defense mechanism. The child's innocent smile vanishes. The bubbly, vivacious childhood disappears only to be replaced by the sadness and the serious. So when the sensitivity got hurt, the traumatic childhood, they become sad and serious. What circumstances make them this? in the childhood, what circumstances make the childhood very traumatic? So there is a fighting between the parents, which leading to insecurity in the childhood, leading to sadness and everything. The parents divorcing and leaving the childhood is over. Again, these circumstances lead to traumatic childhood. Death of the one or both of the parents. Again, they have to take the responsibility and everything they do. Being brought up in uncles or aunts or grandparents' house where there is no liberty. Again, these circumstances can lead to bring up of the savior. Due to financial insufficiencies at home, like too many people to eat and meager income to take care of, this can lead to early taking of responsibility and finally end up with the despair state. Circumstances can lead to the sepia state. There is a mental work at the childhood state. There is a sexual abuse in the childhood that can lead to development of the sepia. So such circumstances, the child loses his or her childhood very early, and unusual responsibility in young shoulder forces the child to mature very easily into sad, melancholic person who does not want or does not know what amusement is and does not want to enjoy the life, and finally blended into sadness, and work has only the part of their life. So physical sura, there is a weakness, faintness, trembling, weakness in the pit of stomach, not relieved by eating, all gone empty sensations in epigastrium, abdomen, taste is altered, longing for the acids and pickles which relieves. So this sura get transferred into psychosis. So exactly the opposite picture of sensitized by business, chaos, disappointment, deception, grief, and mortifications can lead to psychosis. So what psychosis? In psychosis, the face becomes shallow, eyes surrounded by the dark ring, there is a butterfly pigmentation on the cheeks, across the bridge of the nose, puffy, flabby, and the drooping of eyelid. This is the physical presentation of psychosis in sepia. They become very quiet and introverted. They are low-spirited, sad, melancholic, cry easily like pulsatilla. Sadness is associated with irritability, brooding over past disagreeable events, and mental dullness. Mental dullness is the hallmark of the sepia. Mental dullness is a hallmark of the sepia, and there is anger from trifling contradictions. Genetically, they are very careful and fastidious, because we saw the washerwoman remedy. In spite of they don't like dirty clothes, even the clothes are getting worse, again she was. So genetically, they are very careful and fastidious. They are very ambitious person, but ambitious is more toward earning of money only. In psychosis, they become avarice. They are career-oriented women. They do not bother about their family. They go on working hard, late in the office or on money or positions. So this is lot of greed and this desire to lot of money. And the greed actually stems from the fear of poverty. So this is psychosis comes out of fear of poverty. Sepia has constant fear that they may not have anything in the future. So sepia puts all his energy in accumulating wealth as well as very stingy in spending. Avarice is also out of greed, a desire to have a lot of money, as sepia is concerned about social position. Sepia has a false belief that she is poor. She has not enough. So there is a delusion poor she is. And due to this delusion poor and poverty and fear and future pending fear of starvations in the families and everything, they may suffer with the liver affections. And due to that liver affection, there is a yellowness on the face, ichthyosis on the face, fatty liver in the liver. These are the situations in psychosis. So avarice in hypopsychosis, the sepia does not spend money easily on account of fear of poverty, because the perception is that he is very poor. And she feels that there is no enough money, that he does not earn a lot now and his family will starve. So this process leading to affection of the liver. mostly fatty liver. As body shifts gear to psychosis, her sensitivity of contradictions increases further, and she becomes very spiteful, especially toward those who love the best. She permits no opposition to her opinion. She is very argumentative in nature, very angry, irritable, and cannot withstand a least contradiction like Faram. But Faram cannot oppose. Faram says, I am right. And Sepia is very argumentative. They are very critical, dictatorial, dominating. In spite of going through many hardships in the life, they are very positive. But they are negatively positive. They feel, in spite of all the misery they are going through, they must go on working and going ahead in life, either for their family, children, or themselves. Thus, there is positivity in psychosis, and the body has not yet shifted gear to syphilis to let the indifference creep in. So, in psychosis, the sepia is very positive. Thus, this sad, melancholic, dull sepia in psychosis hate consolations, which aggravate her and become non-diligent. In psychosyphilis, there is a strong aversion to company, yet dreads being alone. The mind becomes very stupid, dull, slow, and forgetfulness. This is the hallmark of the sepia. Dullness is of intellect is the hallmark of the sepia. The face is puffed, round, marked by absence of the lines and angle of intelligence. So even mind also dull, and the expression on the face also shows there is a dullness, absence of lines and angle of intelligence. So physical of psychosis, most of psychosis going into looseness and laxness of the particular tissues. So in a relaxation of the tissues and the general weakness, joint feel weak and easily dislocation because of relaxation of tissue. Venous congestion because of looseness of the vessels. Prolapse of uterus because of looseness of the ligament. Portal stasis, liver heavy and sluggishness because of looseness. Sluggishness in the circulations. Sphincter are weak because of looseness. Rectum flawless because of looseness. So looseness, laxity of the tissue and torpidity are the hallmark of the sepia. Drooping of eyelid because of looseness. Weakness of the connective tissue, hence weakness of the joints. Joints gives out easily when walking. This is what the physical of psychosis of the sepia. Now we are entering into syphilitic mode of the sepia. So we have a syphilitic ailments from. So in a syphilitic ailment from in a childhood, the trauma of sexual abuse goes into syphilis. So sexual abuse, a rape, a debauchery, or mental or physical embarrassment, or a fright that can lead sepia land up into syphilis. So this element can lead to the syphilis. Now, what is the syphilis? Syphilis is the only indifference. In the syphilitic miasm, sepia abolishes the ability to feel natural love, to be affectionate. Can describe beautifully that mother says, I know I ought to love my children and my husband. I used to love them, but now I have no feeling on the subject. And she does not feel love, nor can she express love. This is can beautifully explain as stifled affections. So affections are stifled. Stoical state of mind comes in. Indifferent, she will not care for her household affairs or even for her family. There is an absence of joy. Total absence of joy. When they don't want company, aversion to company, and totally misanthropy, which means she hates people. There is a complete disinterest and aversion to everything, especially her family and children. In psychosyphilis, sepia has a strong aversion for company, avoid the sight of the people. You will often see a bedridden patient sleeping, turning toward the wall so that he does not see anyone nor talk to anyone. Or they lie with their eye closed. So this shows that there is an indifferentness. When you visit something in an ICU bed or in a hospital visit, and you find this kind of postures, and they are not taking interest of anything, just think of sepia. This indifferent state comes in after delivery, during nursing the child or twins who require much lacteal fluid and drag her down. It comes in a woman who has an over-vigorous husband. Excessive overindulgence and sexual excitement brings on coldness and she becomes a cold woman. Those is interesting, the questions and everything. And it could also come after living a great misery and overworking for her existence, disgust for life, and finally tendency to suicide. There is a miserable existence of life. When sepia goes into hysterical state, so in a hysteria, hysteria seen in a big way in a syphilitic miasm, her sensitivity got heightened. She cannot tolerate a least contradiction. Things must go her way and breaks out in a spell of weeping, alternating with the sadness. In 1 minute, there is a sadness. 1 minute, there is a weeping. 1 minute, there is a yielding. 1 minute, there is a cheerfulness. They become gentle, yielding. And another, she is disagreeable, excitable, and obstinate. So you don't understand what she is doing next. When you think what she is, when you don't understand or don't know what she is doing next, this is the hysteria of sepia. Physically, sir has mentioned it very beautifully, ulcer about the joints, especially about the joints of the finger. When you find ulcer on the joints of the finger, the physical entry point is sepia. So what are the eliminating point of sepia? So when you find out and out extroverted person, eliminate the sepia. When you find person who likes consolation, pull out sepia. When you find person, lethargic person who does not like physical work, pull out sepia. Because even though lethargy, they like exercises, they like work, they like dancing and everything. That's why when you find lethargic person who does not like physical work, rule out sepia. When you find obese, flabby person, rule out sepia. When you find more fearful person, rule out sepia. When you find emotional person with a strong attachment to family, rule out sepia. The last point you can consider also and you can rule out also, because when you find weak will person, you can rule out sepia. But when sepia goes into autoimmune process called as antagonism or weakness of the will, then you can enter with this rubric, weak will person. Okay. But in a psychosis, they are very strong and positive. So in a psychotic, you can rule out with weak will persons. Some of the clinical applications of the sepia by our stalwarts. So first is sepia is treasure in sinusitis, said by Elizabeth Hobart. Sensation as if fetus in uterus stop moving inside the uterus. Give sepia 1 mL. When potency is mentioned by Dr. C.B. Nair, her clinical experience. Whenever you get head nodding child, think of possibility of sepia. Head nodding. Okay. The best remedy we have for small ulcer about the joint of the finger is sepia, said by Dr. Farrington. And Vijayakar sir also used this in clinical practice and got wonderful results. That's why sir is mentioning the rubric, ulcer of the small joints. When you find history of the bed wetting in early life, it is a good point to prescribe sepia. Dr. T. Douglas Ross. So thank you all. Thank you all learners. It's my little effort to make you understand sepia and my little experience I have shared with you. Thank you all. Hope you all like. Hope you all like the session. Any questions, answer? Any questions you have so far? Since I have one or two questions, hope you got all the answers. Yes, there is one question by Dr. Imran Sheikh. What is the theory behind that ring-like lesion in sepia? See, by looking at the rubric, and sir has used that rubric clinically in their practice, that's why there is no theory behind. Still, I have explanation. Sir has explained, but I didn't have explanation about that things. So, hope you got my point.
Recording stopped.
Yeah.